Previously, we have created a storage to save scraped data in MySQL database. The next step is to store saved images on disk. To be able to work with the file system asynchronously, we need to pull a new package. This one called React.php file system. Copy this, paste, and let's start. First of all, we need to create a file system object. Consider it as an entry point to the entire file system. Then pass this object inside the closure. After saving data to the database, we want to store images on disk. So we loop through images, and for each of them, we instantiate a file. Call file system file. This method requires a path on disk. And we can use a file name from the source of the image. To refresh in memory, this is how the source of the image looks like. It contains path to the file and some query string here. We don't need this query, so let's fix it first. Open the scraper and here we rename it to raw source. Then extract a substring from the beginning to the question mark. This will remove everything after the file name. Done, the source is now fixed. Move back to the main script. Now we are going to store saved images in downloads folder. First created, then built a path to the file. Current working directory, then downloads folder, and extract a file name with base name function. Pass this path to the file call. This call returns an instance of the file. It is just a representation of the real file. At this moment, there is no interaction with the disk. We need to open a file first. Method open accepts the same flags as native fopen function does. To create a file in a writable mode, we pass cw here. The method returns a promise that resolves with an instance of the stream. We are opening a file in a writable mode. That means that in our case, it will be a writable stream. Instead of working with promises, we can use a handy function unwrapWritable to extract a stream from the future promise resolution. Now variable stream contains an instance of the writable stream, which acts like a proxy to the future promise resolution. And the last step is to request the source of the image and pipe its contents to the file stream. So we need a browser here. By default, the browser caches its responses, but we need a raw stream. In this case, provide an option and set streaming to true. Make get request to the source of the image. It returns a promise, we add a handler, response interface, and input class name. Inside the promise, once we start receiving the response, we pipe its body to the local file. That's it. Let's try. Run the script. Wait a bit. Done. Check the folder. And here are our asynchronously saved images. The first one and the second. Okay, the code works, so let's make some improvements, because now it looks a bit messy. I want to extract this file system logic into its own class. Let's say downloader. New class. This class will be responsible for downloading images, and thus it requires browser to perform HTTP requests, file system to work with local files, and a path to the folder, where we will keep our files. Let's remove these doc blocks and an empty line here. Then public method download that accepts URL and returns nothing. Go to the main script, select everything and move this logic right here. Fix variables, replace source of the image with the URL, add this where necessary and replace constant with the saved directory. Fix browser and URL here. Import class name. While we are here, let's extract a method for opening a file. Remove dog blocks, inline here. Okay, the class is done. Now open the main script and instantiate downloader. By the way, we can provide already streaming browser here in the constructor, a file system object and a path to downloads folder. Then we pass this object inside the closure and replace here everything with a single download call. Let's run it. Remove files first and run the script. Our refactoring works, files have been downloaded. But you know, this code still looks weird. Why? Because here everything happens asynchronously. For example, we don't want to save data to the database if the file wasn't stored on disk. This data will be useless without a file. But now we are downloading files and saving data to the database in parallel. How we can fix it? We need to somehow sequentially execute this code. Once the file is stored, we save data to the database. For this purpose, we can use promises. Let's say that download call returns a promise that resolves once the file is downloaded. Then we save the data to the database. So we open downloader and update it. In method download, create a deferred object. Once the file is closed, we resolve it. And return a promise. What will happen? Here we pipe data from the response into the local file. And once the response is done, the local file will be closed, and thus the promise will be resolved. Then go back to the main script and here remove the storage call. And continue chaining with downloader. Once the download is done, then we use image and storage and save this image to the database. Okay, clear the table, remove files and run the script. It works. Files are downloaded and the table has two records. The code now works sequentially. We download a file and once it is stored on disk, we save data to the database. The code works but looks ugly. This nested callbacks, loops, passing around variables with use statements. It definitely requires refactoring. We can move all this logic inside the scraper itself, because actually this code describes details of scraping. Let's go to scraper. This HTML passing can be extracted to its own class. For example, a crawler, a wrapper on top of Symfony crawler. Create a new class named crawler. It requires an instance of browser. Create public method extract image from URL. It accepts a string and returns an instance of promise interface. Then copy and paste code from here. The first method. Then the second one. Our own class is named crawler, so let's make an alias for Symfony crawler. Copy it from here. Add alias Symfony crawler and fix class name here. Done. Method extract image from URL returns a promise that resolves with an instance of image. Move back to scraper. Here we don't need browser anymore. Instead, inject our new crawler and remove input of Symfony crawler. Then here in the loop, Call the crawler. And remove these two methods. Okay, the next step is to move storage and downloader here. Inject them in the constructor. Initialize fields. Replace array map with for each loop. Okay, you remember that the crawler returns a promise that resolves with an instance of image object. At first, we download this image and save it on disk. To continue chaining promises, we return image from this callback. Then we add one more callback. Here we save the image data to the database. Done. Replace the return type to void and remove return statement here. This code looks much better than the previous loop with nested promises. Actually, you can read it as text. We receive URL, extract image from it, then we download a file from this image, and once the file is stored, we save this image to the database. Remove everything here. Now let's compose our scraper. We need a crawler, a storage, and downloader. Let's prove that our refactoring was successful and everything still works. Remove files, clear the table, and run the script. The script is done. Check files and the table. Everything still works. Now the scraper just orchestrates the work of crawler, storage, and downloader. Each task is located in its own class.